Hi, my name is Stuart Russell, and today I'll be showing you how to make the light touch switch from Makers Making Change. The first thing you'll need to do is locate your switch parts, and you might see that on the 3D printed parts there's some excess material. You can break that or cut that off. You need to remove it. Usually it comes off quite cleanly. Sometimes it doesn't. You might want to use a craft knife to help clean it up. It might not end up looking very good, but most importantly is that it needs to fit. The two parts need to fit together smoothly and be able to move. So if there's anything left over, you can leave that. It's probably okay. So the next part is you take the switch unit itself, and you straighten out the legs a bit, and using the flush cutters, remove the just two of the legs on one side. Be careful where these can go, they can sometimes fly off. And on the other side, don't cut these off, but straighten them out. You can use pliers for this if you wish. These should be about 90 degrees to the body of the switch. The other thing we need to do is there are two little locating pegs in the back of the switch. We need to cut them off because our design doesn't need them. Again, you can use the flush cutters for that, and they come off really easily. It's soft plastic. So that's the switch prepared. So you can set that aside for now. Now we need to take the audio cable. Now, if you've received one that has a connector on both ends, you need to cut it in half. I've already cut it in half, as you can see. So we've got a connector on one end and a bare end on the other. If it's already cut in half, don't cut in half again, otherwise the cable will end up too short. So the next thing you have to do is strip back the insulation. That's about 2 centimeters you need to take off. It's about that. You can use the largest hole in the wire stripper, but you have to kind of be a little careful. Don't push it all the way in, just gently kind of nibble away at it. And you'll notice it slowly cuts through and leaves a sharp cut in the insulation. Now, this next part, you have an inner wire and some outer wire strands. These copper wire strands on the outside, make sure none of them are adhering to the main wire. If you accidentally get one of these involved with the main wire and solder it in place and don't notice it, you'll find that your switch won't work. It's quite a common problem. So what I'm doing now is I'm twisting the cable, the loose wires together, so that they don't go everywhere. And then on the other side, I want to strip this back almost as far, but not quite. Usually like the 24 wire gauge setting will do to take this off. So most, if not all the way in. So just squeeze it and pull gently. And you'll see I've cut the insulation there. And as you pull this off, you can twist it a little, which means you get a really tidy set of wires. I'll just retwist this insulation a bit. Now, you need to pick up your switch again and lay it along the wires. And you take one of the wires and wrap it around one of the legs. This might not be very clear because it's very, very small. And you can take the other wire and wrap that around the other leg. I find it helps to wrap them in opposite directions because it means you don't accidentally get them touching. Just make sure that these aren't touching in any way, because if they are, you won't get a switch that works. So once you've twisted these round, and some people might want to use the needle nose pliers to do this, but I've used my fingers. Carefully hold the wire and the switch and unfold it so it's lying along. It's no longer underneath, but it's lying along the sticking out from the front of the switch. You might notice that your connectors are getting a little close here. Use whatever you can to separate them, because you really, really don't want them touching. We have a switch soldering stand, which you might find useful. You can put the switch in, put the cable in, and it should stop it from flopping about too much. If it decides to come out, you might want to put a tool on top of the cable so it doesn't wander about. And now we're ready to solder. So I've got my soldering iron preheated here, and I've just cleaned it off. Now, it'd be really nice if I could zoom in a bit more. Not that far. And what I need to do now is solder each of these legs. Put a little drop of solder on the iron, and then melt some solder onto the leg, hold it for a second or so, and take it away. And then do it for the other one. You'll see I got a bit of extra smoke there when I accidentally melted some of the switch, but that's not too big a problem. And then clean off your iron and put it away. You probably don't need the iron again, so you can turn it off if you don't need it. I'm just putting the hot glue gun on, so it'll be up to temperature by the time we're ready to go. So we can take this out of the stand, and it looks like it should work. It's not very pretty, but it should work. If you have a switch tester handy, you can get that and try it at this stage. This is our dice turner in a delightful shade of horrible. So we can plug this in. Let me zoom back out. And it's a good sign. I plugged it in, it didn't run. And when I tap the switch, it does. So that means we're good. So there's some opportunity to make a mistake, but we've done the hard part of the soldering. So, while I wait for the hot glue gun to warm up, I'll get the bottom part of the switch ready. What we need to do here is put a small amount of glue in here to hold the switch. Some hot glue guns leak everywhere, some of them don't. This one either hasn't warmed up or doesn't leak, and it hasn't warmed up yet. Talk amongst yourselves, edit this bit out. Oh, and here we go, so we need to put a little dot of glue where the switch goes. And I mean just a little. Put the hot glue gun aside, and then press the switch in place. And that should hold it. Then the next thing we need to do is fill the strain relief with glue so that the switch won't tear out. Just be a little careful that you don't overfill it, but kind of fill up the space as well as you can. It's very stringy. And let it cool for a bit. Oops. Just unplug the glue gun so it doesn't go everywhere. If there's extra glue on the side of the switch, you can remove that. It stays warmer than you'd think for longer. So just be a little careful. Okay, so the next thing that we have to do is get the switch top ready. And we can put that in place. And you should be able to feel the switch clicking quite cleanly. Now, depending on the kit you've got, you might have some quite different materials to use as the hinge for the switch. I have a bamboo skewer here, and I'll admit I've sanded it slightly down to size to cut off some time. But you need to make this fit so that it will slide in but not slide out. You have to kind of lightly force it in, but it won't fall out of its own accord. So you might need to round it off a little with some sandpaper, or even the craft knife to like shave bits off, whatever works for you. And then you take the skewer. That doesn't quite go in. Needs a little bit more. You should be able to get it at least flush with the other side, maybe a little bit through. And just check that it will still click, that it's not jammed. And you might have to adjust this or trim this or sand this a bit more to get it right. Once you've got it through and in a way that you like, trim the ends off with the flush cutters. Now, be a little careful here, the ends will go everywhere. This is why we have safety glasses when we're doing this. And then on the other side, you can trim that flush. And you've built a light touch switch. Thank you very much. Oh, and before we go, just to make sure it really works and it's not. There we go. Thank you very much.